The G20 summit in Argentina took place at a moment when the United States still stands at the center of the world. The U.S. economy is booming, the dollar is almighty, American tech companies continue to dominate the new digital economy, and the U.S. military remains the unrivaled master of land, sea, and sky. But there are forces, both short-term and long-term, that are working to erode this hegemony. As Morgan Stanley's Ruchir Sharma points out, the economy is looking like peak America. U.S. stocks have outperformed the rest of the world this decade, and that sort of trend rarely lasts. The current recovery is now the second longest in history, and it is due for a downturn. Interest rates are rising, corporate profit growth is slowing, and budget deficits are surging. Even President Trump seems aware of the likelihood of a dip, which is why he has been preparing the ground for it by blaming the Federal Reserve for raising interest rates. But there are broader structural realities at work as well. While the United States continues to outperform other advanced economies, the rise of the rest also continues, with China, the world's second largest economy, growing at three times the pace of America. A quarter century ago, China accounted for less than 2% of the global economy. Today, it is 15% and rising. China boasts 9 of the world's 20 most valuable tech companies. This economic reality is having a geopolitical effect. China is the largest trading partner of major economies in Latin America, Africa, and Asia. That gives it clout. Its Belt and Road Initiative is designed to extend Beijing's influence across Asia and beyond, creating not just a market, but also a string of allies and dependencies. It has expanded its control over the South China Sea in ways that neither the Obama administration nor the Trump administration has been able to block or counter. Foreign leaders note that the U.S. is also likely to be increasingly constrained by its mounting budget woes. The Financial Times' Gillian Tett points out that the U.S. federal government now spends $1.4 billion a day on its debt, 10 times more than the next major industrialized country does. As interest rates rise and more Americans reach the age of collecting Social Security and Medicare, the federal government will be tightly constrained. Ezra Klein has quipped that the American government is an insurance conglomerate protected by a large standing army. And soon that might well be true. American retreat will not produce a better world. It will be messier and uglier. At a time when these forces of entropy are intensifying, when America does face real constraints on what it can do internationally, the wisest strategy would be to bolster the international institutions and norms that Washington built after World War II, both to maintain some degree of stability and order, but also to preserve and extend American interests and values. The smartest path to constraining China comes not from a head-on policy of containment, but rather from a subtle one that forces Beijing to remain enmeshed and interdependent with other countries. China recognizes this and tries hard to free itself of multilateral groups, preferring to deal one-on-one with countries where its power will always overshadow the negotiating partner. And yet nothing animates the Trump administration more than its opposition to multilateralism of any kind. And so, as the world gets more chaotic, the forces that could provide order are being eroded. And as is so often the case, China simply watches quietly and pockets the gains.